I think there are two answers to this question. One is you must be able to engage at the top level and engage openly and candidly to address the basic issue between the two, which is that China is growing and its growth has to be accommodated, and other countries have to adjust, and China has to adjust. And this is the first basic thing which has to be accepted and understood by both sides, and then individual issues can be discussed within that context. It's not easy to do because both sides have got very set narratives as to what the events mean and whether the developments have been well-intentioned or have had some ulterior purpose, or there's some move being made which is planned for some future objectives. But unless this basic premise is debated, at least we agree on this, then you can go forward and you can discuss specific issues. Then when you discuss the specific issues, you have to look at them on their merits and try to resolve them one by one. If you try to deal with trade and you bring in other considerations, that's going to make it very difficult to solve the trade issues. If you look at the trade issues on their own merits, they can be resolved. If you're looking at technology issues, they can be resolved. If you want to deal with cybersecurity, that's harder. But on its own merits, you can discuss what are the things which need to be done in order to establish rules, in order to establish trust, in order to be able to work together rather than always to be at loggerheads. And you deal with each of the issues one by one, and slowly in the process, you get trust. Slowly in the process, we make progress. It's not a magic solution, but I think that you have to think of it top down and also individually on the issues. As for what small countries can do to actively avoid taking sides, well, we do our best to try to be friends with both and to maintain our relationships with both and develop ties, whether it's economic, whether it's trade, whether it's human resource development, whether it's diplomatic relations, even security exchanges and visits and exercises and commemorations. We maintain links with both sides. But to actively avoid taking sides actually also requires actively not being pressured to take sides. And unfortunately, when the lines start to get drawn, everybody asks, are you my friend or not my friend? And that makes it difficult for the small countries. We must expect sometimes to be asked these questions, and the answer is, well, I'm friends with you, but I have many friends, and that's the way the world has to be. And if it were not, I think it would be a much unhappier world.